call to order the Gurnee Village Board meeting, July 25th, 2022. Roll call, please.
Woodside. Ross. Garner.
Here.
O'Brien.
Present.
Baumus.
Present.
Thorstensen.
Here.
One absent.
Now stand with me for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hello, everybody. So, first item is approval of consent agendas presented.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Baumus, second by Trustee Garner. Roll call, please.
Ross.
Aye.
Garner.
Aye.
O'Brien.
Aye.
Baumus.
Aye.
Thorstensen.
Yes.
All ayes, one absent.
Motion carries. Pat.
Item number one, approval of the minutes from the July 11th, 2022 meeting. Item number two, approval of granting a fireworks permit for Gurnee Days on August 6, 2022. Item number three, approval of granting a temporary Class 9 liquor license to St. Paul the Apostle Church for an event to be held on July 30th, 2022 at 6401 Gages Lake Road. Item number four, approval of Engineering Division recommendation to award the Grove Avenue Stormwater Improvement Project to the low bidder, Excavating Inc., at a cost of $57,540. Item number five, approval of payroll for period ending July 15, 2022 in the amount of $1,009,628.71. Item number six, approval of bills for period ending July 25th, 2022 in the amount of $866,156.27.
Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Garner, second by Trustee O'Brien. Roll call, please.
Ross.
Aye.
Garner.
Aye.
O'Brien.
Aye.
Baumus.
Aye.
Thorstensen.
Yes.
All ayes, one absent.
All right. Moving on to petitions and communications. First item is to a proclamation honoring Kevin Woodside. Kevin indicated he couldn't be here tonight. How appropriate, right? What we're gonna, I told him that we were going to say lots of good things about him, even if he wasn't gonna be here. So, even before I start the proclamation, I just wanted to say that you'll hear a lot of things about things he's done, and he's done a lot, and he's been a great man for the village of Gurnee. But just as much as that's the case, it's the qualities of an individual that I think Kevin goes well beyond in terms of his integrity, that he just the kindness that he exudes, all those things that you'd expect in just a great man. So I do want to recite the things he's done, but I think that's even more important, is that he's a man that you can respect and honor, and that's what we plan on doing. So I'll start off. Whereas for nearly 50 years, a deserving individual or couple has been selected to be honored during the annual Gurnee Days celebration, and whereas the Gurnee Days Committee has selected Kevin Woodside as the 2022 Gurnee Days honoree, whereas the Gurnee Village Board wishes to recognize Kevin as a longtime resident, volunteer, and community leader, whereas Kevin served the Village of Gurnee Department for Police Department for 30 years, being hired as a police officer in 1988, and progressing through the ranks, culminating his appointment as Chief of Police in November of 2011, which continued until his retirement in January 1st, 2019. Notable achievements under his leadership included establishment of the visitor-oriented policing teams, and the introduction of lateral hiring for police officers, development of the body-worn camera program, introduction of taser-conducted electrical weapons, and establishment of a consolidated dispatch area with the City of Zion, just to name a few. Whereas Kevin desired to continue to serve the Village of Gurnee and begin a career of local government service in 2021 as a Village Trustee, and whereas Kevin also contributes his time and resources by serving as a longtime member of the Gurnee Exchange Club, including two terms as President, and whereas Kevin serves as a member of the Board of Directors of PADS Lake County, whereas Kevin has been active in his church, and he and his wife Kathy have attended for the last 20 years, serving on the Board of Elders, volunteering with the food pantry and other ministries. Whereas Kevin has made and continues to make a profound impact on Gurnee in a multitude of ways through his commitment to service and community betterment. Whereas in the tradition of Gurnee Days honoree, Kevin Woodside is a stellar example of the very best of Gurnee and a reflection of the values of the community that we call home. Now therefore, be it proclaimed by the Board of Trustees of the Village of Gurnee, that on Friday, August 5th, 2022, be recognized as Kevin Woodside Day throughout the Village of Gurnee. Be it further proclaimed that the Village congratulates Kevin Woodside on his selection as the 2022 Gurnee Days honoree, and that a copy of this proclamation being presented to him at a reception in his honor on Friday, August 5th, 2022. So, is there a motion?
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Ross, second by Trustee Thorstensen. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
And specifically with reference to that, you can buy tickets on Eventbrite, is that correct?
Yep.
And it's $20 a ticket, and they're looking to have a count by July.
Yeah, the deadline was supposed to be today. We're going to extend it to August 1st.
Oh, you are?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Thanks. All right. Second petition communication is approval of proclamation designated August 7th through the 13th, 2022 as National Stop on Red Week, Stop on Red Week in the Village of Gurnee. National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the American Trauma Society established National Stop on Red Week to set aside 1 week of every year to raise public awareness about this completely preventable and deadly form of aggressive driving. According to the Insurance Institute for Hawaii, it'd be nice if it'd be in Hawaii, highway safety red light running and the leading cause of urban crashes, resulting in over 900 deaths and 116,000 injuries nationally in 2020. The Gurnee Police Department works to reduce red light running through public education and safety programs, proactive traffic enforcement, and a photo enforcement program. These efforts seek to reestablish respect for the traffic signals to enhance the safety of all of our residents and visitors. Now, therefore, I, Mayor Thomas Hood, do proclaim that the week of August 7th through August 13th is hereby designated as 2022 National Stop on Red Week in the Village of Gurnee. I urge everyone to reduce crashes, injuries, and the tragic loss of life by stopping for red lights. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Trustee O'Brien, second by Trustee Thorstensen. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Motion carries. All right, so Pat, no reports.
Correct.
No old business.
No.
On the new business, approval of ordinance
2022-44,
authorizing the execution of an intergovernmental agreement regarding the development of the plan and agreement to consolidate participating Lake County public safety answering points. Okay.
Sure. So we've talked about this a couple times. You had a memo from me on it. As you know, county's been looking at opportunities to increase public safety and consolidate dispatch services for a number of years. We've been involved in that greatly since the beginning, since those discussions started, taking steps along the way to move towards that effort. One big step was getting everybody on the same, we're working to get everybody on the same platforms as far as the software that's used. The Village Board approved Gurnee moving in that direction with participating partners in June of this year. That was a pretty big step forward, but the most impactful step that's taken place to date was in October of last year when the Lake County Board authorized agreement for the design and construction of a $40 million consolidated 911 and emergency operations center down in Libertyville at their Lake County campus. So that's currently being designed. They're hoping to have the design done by the end of 2022, with it opened in 2025. There are, in relation to that, they've asked eight PSAPs in Lake County to participate in developing the entity that would run the center. So Lake County is gonna build the center, and then the thought is that a separate governing entity would operate and house the center. So Lake County had developed what has been termed this implementing agreement, asked the eight PSAPs if they'd like to participate through that agreement. As part of that, they're looking for $50,000 contribution from each to help hire a project manager and cover other costs. The eight PSAPs that they've invited to participate are Lake County Sheriff, Foxcom, CENCOM, Lake Zurich, Mundelein, Vernon Hills, Waukegan, and Gurnee. The seven have approved it. Gurnee is the last in line to consider it. As we've talked about throughout this whole thing, you know, the main focus from Gurnee as we participate in these meetings is maintaining or improving the quality of service to our residents, and then ensuring that our current employees have the ability to benefit from this initiative. So that's always been our focus. Probably a month ago, the mayor, myself, Police Chief Smith, Fire Chief Kavanaugh, Communications Supervisor Jones, as well as the communications shift leaders, met with the communications employees to give them an update as far as where we're at in the process and let them know that this agreement was coming. The group appreciated the face-to-face sit-down and the time we provided. There was a lot of questions that we can't answer quite yet because this process is just getting going, but we did commit to having regular, or provide regular information to them as far as the progress that's been made. Obviously soliciting their feedback along the way. They're the ones that are doing this on a day-to-day basis, so they're gonna have a huge say in what this thing looks like when it's all said and done. This implementing IGA going forward, they've asked each PSAP to designate a representative, one representative. Staff is recommending Chief Kavanaugh. He's been heavily involved in this process since the beginning. Has a good understanding of how our center operates, what our needs are, what our hot button issues are. So staff is recommending him. This agreement, they anticipate will take 12 to 18 months to work out what this entity will look like. At that point, we'll be back before you again. We anticipate with another agreement, and that's the are you in or out agreement. Are you gonna join this new entity or not? So we will actively participate as we have from the beginning of this process, voice our concerns, work to make sure that it's a quality entity that meets our needs, meets our personnel's need if they transition to this entity. And then again, we'll have what looks like one final chance that if we don't want to consolidate to a consolidated center to get out. So again, that's probably 12 to 18 months out. This agreement signifies our willingness to help to develop this new entity.
All right, are there questions or comments?
Make a motion to approve.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Balmus, second by Trustee Garner. Roll call, please.
Ross?
Aye.
Garner?
Aye.
O'Brien?
Aye.
Balmus?
Aye.
Thorstenson?
Yes.
All ayes, one absent.
Motion carries. So item number two, approval of ordinance 2022-45. Authorizing the execution of a first restatement of the management agreement with Golf Vision Management, Inc. for the Bittersweet Golf Course. Pat?
Sure. So I'm not sure how 10 years has gone by so fast, but Golf Visions has been out of the course, managing it for us since 2012, following an RFP process. We selected them. They had 2 5-year agreements. So those are coming up for expiration. The second 5-year agreement's coming up for expiration this November. Staff has been very happy with how the course has progressed over the past 10 years, done a great job as far as making it more playable. Just sprucing it up around the edges with equipment, long-term capital. Kathy, Brad, Hannah, when Rich was out there, all did a great job, great feedback from the public and those that play out there. So staff is recommending to continue forward with Golf Visions. Golf Visions wasn't looking for any changes to the contract whatsoever, so the dollar amount to manage the course stays the same. The annual incentive percentage stays the same. The only term that's changing in the contract is just re-upping it instead of 5 years. Excuse me. Golf Visions requested 6, not a big deal from staff's perspective. Some of the terms in the contract that carry forward, Golf Visions is responsible for all the management, operation, and maintenance and marketing of the course. They have regular meetings with staff to discuss issues, plan for the future. They provide us monthly financial reports. They take care of all the human resource functions. They prepare the budget, handle insurance. And as I said, the annual management fee remains $39,000 per year. There's no annual escalator in there. The annual incentive fee is 15% of gross revenues exceeding $1.25 million. And it's a 6-year term. So Kathy Ralston's here. She's the general manager of the course. If there's any questions from the village board. But again, staff has been very pleased with how things have operated out there. Myself, Chief Kavanaugh, and Brian Gosnell are the main 3 points of contact for the course. John and Brian Golf, I do not, so I rely on them as far as the shape of the course and what they're hearing from players, and I'm more there from the financial aspect. So things have ran smoothly, staff is happy, and if it's not broke, there's no reason to fix it. So we're recommending to continue forward with Golf Visions.
Kathy, would you like to just step up and maybe tell us how it's going so far this year? Yeah, right up to the microphone.
I am happy to report that
Well, as you all know, and we talked about this last year, golf has been one of the few growth industries or growth sectors coming out of the pandemic. And the big question mark over 2022 was whether we would be able to sustain golf's resurgence when life returned to pretty much normal. All competing activities, youth sports are back in full swing. And the good news is pretty much, yes, you know, golf is still enjoying a resurgence in interest, participation. I was looking at the numbers right before I came over here. We actually have a chance this July to break the record in revenues that we set last year in 2021. We're year to date down a little bit, but that is largely attributable to the poor weather we had in April. I mean, we just had a historically bad April in terms of weather for golf, and that carried into the first 8 to 10 days in May. We had our biggest Father's Day weekend ever, bringing in $32,000 in revenue over 2 days. And we just benefited this past weekend from being in the bittersweet bubble. We got a couple inches of rain, and a lot of courses around us, unfortunately, picked up 4 to 6 inches of rain. So we were open and we were bustling all weekend. So we were already set up to have a really good weekend, and we had an excellent weekend. It looks promising that we will, you know, pending Mother Nature's continued cooperation, have a great year again in 2022. So,
thanks, Kathy.
Any questions?
Trustee Thorstensen.
Hi. I know in the past you've had some music venues there as on Friday night fish fries, and I know you also have some events coming up. Do you have anything like that planned?
We are hosting several outings for the remainder of the year, like large outings, including the mayor's benefit at
That's
the end
right.
of August.
Very large outing, right?
Friday, August 26th.
Pray
20,
to God it's
Friday,
a very
August
large outing,
26th.
Yes.
And still coming up on our docket, we have our in-house events, the Chili Open at the end of September. We have our turkey scramble in at the end of October. We have the Gurnee Police and Fire coming back, Public Works coming back, a lot of returning outings for the balance of the year. And we've had a lot of small to medium-sized groups booking at Bittersweet, too, which is really nice. Bachelor parties. We had the LPGA amateurs out on Saturday. We have a great mix of golfers coming out to Bittersweet. A lot of diversity, and that's great to see. A lot of young people coming into the game. A lot of women coming into the game, which I love to see. And it's just very positive right now from where we sit. And we're looking for ways to extend the golf course to non-golfers mm-hmm. in the community, too, through events like the Families in the Fairway that we hosted with the Village and the Park District back in June. We're having a fun run for Woodland School in September around the perimeter of, I think it's the back nine they're going to run. And we're always looking for ways to do that. Live music, I don't know if that will come back. Just because as soon as we had a couple live music nights, we were contacted about licensing. We haven't ventured into that. Music rights licensing becomes an issue. So we'd have to commit to doing that on a regular basis. Fish fry, unfortunately, I would love to do a fish fry again, but it was difficult to do with the size of our kitchen and having one fryer. So we're sort of landlocked with our kitchen, if any of you have been out to the clubhouse. And if you haven't, I invite you to come out, stop by for a tour, send me an email or give me a call, and I'd be happy to take you around.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Trustee Balmas?
Are you into any consideration of putting the tent back up for outings and that? Is that ever?
I know prior to my tenure, there was, I guess, a semi-permanent tent structure. I don't think we're looking at that being economically sustainable.
That's it. So, Kathy, I just want to thank you, too. Kathy's been awesome in helping me on trying to figure out what an outing's all about. And same with Hannah with the food. It's been a learning process, and thank you for helping me through that. So you've been great.
Yeah, thank you.
So I don't think there's any other questions, so thanks again. Is there a motion?
Second.
Motion by Trustee Garner, second by Trustee O'Brien. Roll call, please.
Ross. Garner.
Aye.
O'Brien.
Aye.
Balmis.
Aye.
Thorstensen.
Yes.
All ayes, one absent.
Motion carries. Thank you, Kathy. You're stuck with us for six more years.
Thank you.
We're on to public comments. Anybody that would like to make a public comment? There being none, is there a motion to adjourn?
Moved.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Balmis, second by Trustee Garner. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion